Hello and welcome to Speak Perfect International. I'm your host, Ohemu Godwin Pius. Thank you so very much for making our time to join us on our YouTube channels today. I want to believe that you must have entered the year 2019, or perhaps you are just few hours to enter into the year 2019. However it is, I am hopeful and confident that each and every one of us, we are going to enter the year 2019. We are going to see the first day of the month of January. We'll equally see the second day of the month of January and even the 31st day of the month of December, to the glory of God. You see, there is no denying that the year 2018 wasn't an easy year for some persons. Some persons actually lost their jobs, some persons dropped out of school, some persons couldn't afford 3 square meals, some persons actually couldn't pursue their dreams because the funds were no longer coming as they expected. And chances are that as we are moving into the new year, some of those difficulties that we experienced in the previous year might also surface in the new year. So to help us address this issue, I will be speaking to us this day on the topic, survival strategies in a challenging economy. Survival strategies in a challenging economy. A few weeks ago, the National Bureau of Statistics made available some information that will be of help to every one of us. It says that 20.9 million Nigerians are currently out of jobs. 20.9 million Nigerians are currently out of jobs. In 2017, our unemployment rate stood at 17.6 million. In 2018, it rose to 20.9 million. And in case you do not know, 20.9 million unemployed Nigerian citizens simply means that Nigeria can boast of a large army of unemployed individuals that nearly equal the population of Israel, the population of Togo, and the population of Kuwait all put together. It simply means that something needs to be done in order for us to be able to survive in the new year, because companies are downsizing, people are being kicked out of offices, things are not working the way some persons actually expected. So to enable us brace the odds is the reason I am before you this day to speak to you on the topic, survival strategies in a challenging economy. For you to survive in a challenging economy, there are 4 major skills that you should be equipped with. There are 4 major information that you should have at the back of your mind. The first one is this: do not wait for the government. Do not wait for the government. Some years back, President John F. Kennedy actually said, ask not what the government can do for you, but ask what you can do for the government. Permit me to say, wait not for the government, but rather take up your plow and go cultivate your garden. Wait not for the government, but rather take up your plow and go cultivate your garden. Financial independence is a self-made path. The government cannot provide all of the things that you need for you to live a richer, a fuller, and a better life in a challenging economy as ours. So I encourage you to take up your plow, find something that you are good at, and develop yourself in that area, and that could become an avenue for you to earn funds that you can use to put food on your table, to clothe yourself, and to live a convenient life. If you feel that waiting for the government is going to solve your situation, then you should get ready to wait for a very, very long time, because experience actually teaches that the government alone cannot provide all the basic necessities of life for our citizens. I encourage you to realize the fact that you are the master of your fate, you are the captain of your soul, and you are your own rescue. Nobody is going to rescue you. You are the architect of your destiny. And whatever you are today or hope to be in life is as a result of the decisions and the actions that you have taken. So, my dear friends, I encourage you, take up your plow and go cultivate your garden. Create that financial independence path for yourself. Wait not for the government. Instead, find something that you can do, something legal that can help you to fend for yourself and able to put food on your table. Point number two, I encourage you as my friend to become a problem solver. Become a problem solver. Look for problems around. Walk around your society. Walk around your immediate environment. You see people who are facing one challenge or the other. Tell them about the problem and sell the solutions to them. I define an entrepreneur as someone who identifies a problem, tell people about the problem and sell the solution of that problem to the people. That is the best way for you to make money, and that is one of the ways in which you can survive in a challenging economy in the year 2019. Become a problem solver. You can solve problem in the in agriculture, you can solve problem in ICT, you can solve problem in education, you can solve problem perhaps in public communication, in whatsoever. There are lots and lots of areas in which you can find problem to solve. And as many persons who can solve human problem, okay, they will make a whole lot of money. And I encourage you to benefit from the resources that we have available out there in your immediate environment. Don't think that success is waiting for you in Canada, in UK, or in Australia. Success is not a native of America or of Canada or of Australia. Success is right inside of you. Find your own acres of diamonds and begin to dig it right now, and begin to exhume all of the precious stones that is readily available in there for you. Become a problem solver. And if you can solve problem, people will not hesitate to get across to you, to invite you, even to fly you down to far distant place, okay, to help them address their issue. So first point, do not wait for the government. Point number two, I encourage you to become a problem solver. Point number three, I encourage you to learn a skill. Learn a skill. In this new year, if you do not have anything that you can do with your hands, perhaps you might want to go and learn something about catering, something about, you know, interior and exterior decoration, web design, graphic design. Perhaps you want to learn how to cut men's hair, you want to learn how to plait ladies' hair. Find something, learn a skill. There are lots and lots of skills out there that you can learn. And as many persons who can learn these skills, they are the ones who will be able to break the odds in a challenging economy in the year 2019. I encourage you, look around you. What are the things that gives you joy? What are the things that you are so passionate about? Invest in yourself. Go learn a skill in that area. Perhaps learn about how to make footwear and all of that. Learn about how to make furniture, how to make office equipment, even how to repair and how to service some machines and instruments in organization. All of these things actually could give you money. My question for young graduates always is, in addition to the certificate that you have in your hand, what can you do with your hand? What skill, what requisite knowledge, what ability do you have apart from the degree that you have in your hand? So, my dear friend, for you to be able to brace the odds in a challenging economy in this new year, number one, you must resolve within yourself that you will not wait for the government, that you will become a problem solver, and that you are going to learn a skill. And finally, I encourage you to get financial literacy. Become financially literate. Some persons actually are walking around in society and they are financial illiterate. They do not know what money is, nor how it works in terms of investment, expenditure, and savings. So I encourage you to understand what money is. Take your time, get books, get materials out there that will help you understand what budgeting is, what an asset is, what a liability is, what saving and what investment is. It will be wrong for you to enter the year 2019 void of all of this requisite knowledge, and you just walking around, and any phone that comes to your hand, you spend it buying liabilities. If you think that buying an iPhone or buying, you know, flashy cars and costly jewelries actually are assets, my dear friend, they are not assets. An asset is anything that will put money in your pocket. And anything that takes money from your pocket without the natural propensity to put money back in your pocket is nothing but liability. If you look at your life very well, perhaps all of the things that, you know, makes up your life are bundles of liabilities. I encourage you to shed off those things as we are entering a new year and take up a new life. Take up a new lifestyle of purchasing assets. Buy things that will help you, things that will help you make more money, okay? You use money to make more money. These are the ways in which you are going to succeed, that you are going to break the odds that will surface in the coming year. And lest I forget, I encourage you to invest in personal development. Develop yourself in a particular area. What is it that gives you interest, that gives you joy? take the time and commit yourself to a continuous and a never-ending improvement strategy. This is how you better yourself, and this is how you become a person of value. You see, when you become a person of value, you don't know how to pursue success. When you become a person of value, success actually will walk after you. And the only way in which you can survive in a challenging economy is when you learn these four tips that I have given unto you. Number one, do not wait for the government. Number two, I encourage you to become a problem solver. Number three, I encourage you to learn a skill. And number four, I encourage you to get financial literacy, get financial education, become financially literate, be equipped with the requisite knowledge that will help you to make sound financial decisions that will help you to make the right choice in every transaction that you engage upon. And I also want to let you know that negotiation is a skill that you should have as someone who is hoping to brace the odds in the coming year. It will be financial foolishness for you to go to the mall or to go to the market and they tell you this commodity costs 5,000 naira and you graciously pay for it. No, there is no financial intelligence in this way. I encourage you to bid, price, negotiate until you, the buyer and the seller, come to a compromise, a win-win situation, such that the seller will be happy to sell that goods for you at that amount, and you, the buyer, you'll be happy to buy that goods at that particular amount. And majorly, I encourage you to please teach your children what saving is. Perhaps you want to get them a piggy bank or a saving box. Let them know that any money that gets into their hand, they should be able to set certain amount of it aside. And you, the adult, I encourage you, perhaps you are a civil servant, perhaps you are self-employed, or perhaps you buy and sell. I encourage you to listen to the old time counsel of Robert Kiyosaki when he said that financial intelligence or financial independence is a self-made path. And I also want you to listen to the old time advice of George S. Clancy when he said 10% of whatever you earn is yours to keep. Any fund that gets to your hand, I encourage you to set aside 10% of that. And as you keep doing this, perhaps you can do it from January to December, and chances are that you get, you know, a whole sum of money, and you can use that to invest in something that will bring you more money. Survival is key, and in 2019, we all must survive. And the best way for you to survive is never you wait for the government. The government cannot provide all of your needs. I encourage you to become a problem solver. Look around you and identify problems and start preferring solutions to those things. Number three, I encourage you to learn a skill. And finally, I encourage you to get financial education. Become financially literate. This is how you are going to excel in the year 2019. Thank you so very much for joining us, and I look forward to reading your comment in the comment box below. And if you like what I've just said, I encourage you to please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Till I come your way again, I remain your brother and friend, Ohemu Godwin Pius, creator and CEO, Speak Perfect International. Bye for now.